Today we are going to learn how to create a table and write an equation based on a visual pattern. I have a visual pattern sitting in front of me right here because I have figure one. This one's figure one. Figure two looks kind of like it, and figure three even looks kind of like it, but I've made some changes. From figure one to figure two, I can see that those three tiles right here are being added. From figure two to figure three, I can see that those three tiles there are being added. So I can see that the pattern is adding those three tiles. Now I need to figure out how many tiles are going to be in figure zero. So if I'm adding three tiles as I increase my figure number, in order to work backwards to find figure zero, I'm going to have to subtract those three tiles. So if I would subtract those three tiles, I would be left with these two. And that is what makes up figure zero. I'd also like to know what figure four looks like. And so I've got to take figure three and add three more tiles to the top in order to get figure four. So there's figure four. So now I have five figures. I have figure zero, I have figure one, two, three, and four. And I'm going to create a table based on this. I've got my table over here for my x and my y. My x values represent these figure numbers: figure 0, figure 1, figure 2, figure 3, figure 4. My y values represents how many tiles are in each figure. So in figure 0, I have two tiles. In figure 1, remember I added those three tiles. So now I have a total of five. In figure 2, I added three more tiles. So now I have a total of eight. In figure three, I added three more tiles for 11 total, and then I added three more for a total of 14 in figure four. So now I need to identify a couple of key things here. I need to identify what I started with, and I need to figure out what I'm growing by. To find the start value, this is where I need to look at my figure zero. I need to know when x is zero, what is my y value? That's going to be my start value. So in this visual pattern, my start value is 2 because that is the number of tiles when I'm in figure 0. Or over in my table, when x is 0, my y value is 2. My growth rate is that pattern. What am I doing every time to the pattern? I'm adding 3. So that is my growth rate. So I've got a start value of 2 and a growth rate of 3. And now I have enough information to write my equation. My equation looks like this. Y is equal to my start value, which is, oops, 2, plus my growth rate times whatever figure I'm in. So if I want to find out how many tiles are in figure 9, I would take 3 times 9, which is 27, and add 2, and I would have 29 tiles in figure 9. So I've created my table and I've created my equation. Now, I'd like to know what the equation would be for anything. I would like to relate growth rate and start value. And so in order to do that, I have to remember that I can also write this equation as y equals 3x plus 2. I need it in this format because I am learning what the general equation of a line is, of a pattern. And that general equation is y equals mx plus b. And if I line these up, I want to identify what this m is and what the b is. So my m is the number in front of x. And over here, that is my growth rate. So m is equal to my growth rate, whereas my start value is in the same place as the b, and so my b is my start value. Sometimes we also call the m, we call that the slope. and we call B the y-intercept. So these are different names for now our visual patterns. So M is also my growth rate and my slope. B is my start value, but it is also my y-intercept. So I have multiple representations for my visual pattern. I have slope, I have the y-intercept, all from looking at three figures, creating a table, and then writing the equation.